Yeah. Reality's a funny thing, isn't it? I mean, not really, it's like horrifically overwhelming, but for the sake of this bit, reality's a funny thing. Yeah. Doesn't matter how far you come, how well you think you're doing, who you think you are, here's reality to tell you otherwise, right? You could be president of the United States of America, right? There I was, Studio 54, Andy Warhol, and I was eating the pussy of the most beautiful Belarusian supermodel. And she said, Donald, you eat pussy better than Mick Jagger. It's true. Reality. Mr. President, this is a corpus for war widows. War widows don't like getting their pussy eaten, I don't get it. It counts for all of us. Now I got bipolar, right? When I'm manic, I'm like a genie from Aladdin, you know? My in my head. And I feel like I can do anything. If you say, Patrick, can you make a musical adaptation of Paul Thomas Anderson's 2007 classic, There Will Be Blood, in 5 minutes? Yes, I can. Reality, letter from the bank. It's just a piece of paper with a box, and it says, tick the box. And I'll stand there for 8 hours going, call all my ex-girlfriends and like, what did you do with the box? What am I meant to do with the box? Draw a little rabbit and the rabbit saying, I like the box. Instant push notification from now, being like, you fucking idiot. That's reality. It humbles you, you know? And this is why power fantasies are so popular. Superhero films, or like say a cartoon like Dragon Ball Z, right? Now fans of that show, they don't see a guy screaming for 22 minutes going, having a nervous breakdown. They see a muscly man powering up. So when they wake up screaming, they don't think, I've wasted my life watching anime. They think, I'm going to become a Super Saiyan. I don't need Zoloft to function, Kakarot. We all want to be Vegeta, Prince of the Saiyans. And this is why fantasy RPG video games like Zelda and Skyrim are so popular. Because you can sink 300 hours into it and you can see yourself go from a peasant to Montaron, Cat Prince of the Assassin Guild, wielder of the Blades of Harnor, slayer of the Lich Demon King of the realm of Krishnash and the celestial beings. It feels good. But even then, the banality of life catches up with you. You finish the big quest and you want to go back to those early little villages, make sure you got everything, you know? You're walking around, there's always one guy like, mate, hey mate, you missed me. You missed me the first time. Come out. Yes, I am Montaron, Cat Prince of the Assassin. Yeah, nah, I read the paper. You got the big demon bloke, cheers, yeah. Nah, I was wondering, like, you want to do me a favor? Oh, like a quest? Will I find dwarven runes? Yeah, maybe. So here's what happened, right? It was the blood moon, and my wife and I, your wife was taken by the blood moon witches. So we finally renovated the patio deck, right? And so I was thinking, it's a good time for me to invite my auntie over for brunch, right? And my aunt, she's fucking hard work, right? But I'm trying to make an effort for my mum's sake, okay? Comes over. She's got this big Tupperware bowl full of casserole. It's great, we're having a fucking lovely morning. She can't help herself though, can she? She can't help herself. She goes out, you know? Hey, what's your sister doing? When's she going back to school, you know? When's your sister going to get a job? Hey, why's your sister so fucking slack? She fucking knows, okay? My sister's having a rough time because of Darren. And she also knows that my sister and my fucking wife are best mates. So my wife gets up in arms, my aunt then gets offended, and she goes storms off in a huff. Oh, she was taken by the storm sorcerers of the Red Coast. Nah, mate, she's just a bitch, right? So she fucked off. Next day, I'm getting ravens, I'm getting letters. Hey, you got my Tupperware container? Hey. When are you going to return my Tupperware container? Hey, you wash my Tupperware container yet? Here's the thing. Usually I wash it, I send it right back. But it's Spring Festival. I'm a peasant. I love the jig. I love the maypoles. So I go up to the spooky forest, right? And I'm going to go pick some blackberries to make my famous blackberry pie for the festival, right? No, I'm there. I've got a Tupperware container. Why the fuck not? It's all for. Aptly named Spooky Forest. Fucking beast pops out, scares the shit out of me, and I run back in. Oh, was the beast the orc chieftain crash land my rival? No, it was my neighbour Davo. He's got a dog named Jonesy. He's a lovely mastiff, but he plays a bit too rough, and he scared me. And I run back here. You want me to slay this Jonesy? No, he's a lovely fucking dog. I run back here, and I realise too late. I left the lid of the Tupperware container in the spooky woods. So, would you do me a massive favour? Oh, slay the Ogre King? No, just go up there on an epic quest, find the lid, it's got red handles, bring it back to me, and don't slay any neighbourhood dogs in the process, if you will. Oh, what will be my reward, my treasure? Mate, okay, first time I saw you 300 hours ago, it's going to give you 10 experience points. What level are you now?
I'm a 9 level 97 dragon paladin!
Right, okay, well I got no fucking money because of the patio, it cost a fortune. But I'll tell you what, get that lid for me, I'll give you a slice of my famous blackberry pie. You spent 300 hours playing this game, and to finish it, you just have to press X to eat pie. And that is what reality is like, it's banal. No matter how many realms you conquer, it brings you back down. And the point I'm making here is, the last 5 minutes of me doing that very cooked Skyrim sketch. I wrote that there would be blood musical you asked me for earlier. Do you want to hear some of it? Of course you do. You asked for it. Anyway, it's that opening scene with Daniel Day-Lewis down in the gold mine, you know. Oh, there will be... pick. There will be dirt. Bum, 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 bum. And there will be... oh, there will be mud. Bum, 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 bum. And there will be... because there's always hurt. Bum, bum. But there will be... oh, there's always... yes, there will be... there will be blood! It writes itself. Thank you. He's a state suing me and he's not even dead. Anyway, point is, right? I'm asking you now, given you there will be blood musical, will one of you normal, sane-ish looking people please come back to my house and help me tick this box? Because I am very fucking confused. And that's reality. Thank you very much.